Up and sail in the wind. What a beautiful morning. You time to go fishing. The water's calm. No ripples, still, smooth like a mirror. We should come out here more often. What do you think?
I know what you're thinking. Artificial doors, live bait for Bess Elizabeth.
Well, I'm sorry, but I could never get comfortable with taking that hook and sparing those little worms you see down at the bay shop.
Real fishermen use live bait.
I know, Dad. You remember this place, Dad? Of course you do. You used to say this was our place. Okay, don't laugh. I used to be really good at this. Remember? You used to pick a spot out there, like a lily pad, or a water bug, or a stick bug or something, and we'd take turns trying to cast right to it. Remember the first time we came out here? I went to cast and I hooked my leg. It was a disaster. I tore my favorite stockings, too. You had to bribe me with a Barbie doll just for me to come back. Bribery. The best way to a little girl's heart. But coming here with you, the second time to our place, that became the bribe. We used to fish all morning and swim all afternoon. And we eat turkey sandwiches and Lay's potato chips. And he let me drink Coke right out of the glass bottle. Mom never let me drink Coke. Yeah, and on the way home, we'd stop and get ice cream for dinner. That place is still open, I think. I'll take you there if you promise to eat something. I won't tell Nurse Joe. Oh, he's beautiful. Is that an egret? Or a heron? You're always so good with birds. How many people these days know all the names of the birds on the lake? Sleep sometimes. She says you call out. What are you dreaming about? Come on, Dad, it's me, Elizabeth. I'm right here. Because there's people who need to see your face, people who need to hear your voice. You gotta fight this darkness that's closing in around you, because your darkness is our darkness. Party. Bobby from the station came by last week to say hello. You were married to Jean.
scary way to come.
It looks like one of those places where murderers ready to attack you and rip out your throat.
What? No, this is quaint. This is a safe, quaint place.
It's really humid out here. Nikki, did you have a mosquito spray?
No.
But I gave you a cute wand.
They won't latch on if we keep moving.
Everyone keep moving. If you don't keep moving, the mosquitoes will suck out your intestines. Wait, no intestines, have you really? What are you letting her watch?
Me?
Nikki, keep moving so you don't get encephalitis. Can we go now?
Watch out, Nikki. Encephalitis is turning into one of the undead.
You're deranged. Nicole Lauren Gilbert. No one is deranged. Al, tell her sister that she isn't deranged.
Apologize to her sister.
Seriously, I'm sorry for calling you deranged.
Great job, Sam. Conflict resolution. Now, Gilbert clan, gather around. This is our new place. Yeah, Dad!
What do you mean, dear?
This is our new place for fam time. Hanging out for summertime adventures.
Okay, I didn't sign up for any summertime adventures.
Can we look for dead bodies now?
What? No more Hulu for you for like 5 months.
Al, where did you find this place?
That's the best part. Nobody knows about it.
What? Are we trespassing?
What? No. Nobody technically owns this place. To look like that.
I can't get in the water. I don't want my phone getting wet.
Just put it in a baggie.
See, I didn't bring a baggie. No one said I would need a baggie.
Forget the baggie. Just don't fall in.
Okay, how am I supposed to forget about the baggie? That is not an easy thing to forget. Especially when you really need one. Now all I'm going to be thinking about is, wow, I really wish I had a baggie.
Forget I said anything about the baggie.
I can't now. The whole idea of how safe my expensive phone will be nestled inside a baggie is burned in my mind.
Okay, then remember the bag.
I remember that.
Is this boat seaworthy, honey?
We aren't actually going to sea.
Is it lake-worthy?
Of course. Now, the first thing we need to do is put on our personal location apparatus.
Too tight. I want to be the Coast Guard.
Mine smells like butt. Honey, I think they all kind of smell like butt.
No, that's the smell of safe.
Okay, that doesn't make any sense.
Al, do you even know how to canoe?
How hard can it be? You just get in and paddle.
Famous last words.
Hey, Champ, let's cheer up, Buttercup. Turn that frown upside down. Come on, this is going to be fun. Think of all the cool wildlife we might see, and we can sing some songs and stuff.
Songs? I think this life vest is suffocating me.
No problem. Better?
No.
Great. I think maybe we should stretch.
What a stretch!
Get limbered up so we can paddle. We had a long car ride. Let's do it. All aboard, me hearties.
Dad, there's only two seats. You may have to sacrifice one.
No. The two of you will sit on the floor of the canoe.
Okay, you.
I want to be the navigator.
Oh, you mean we're supposed to sit where all this green stuff is growing?
Oh, that's algae or kelp or something.
Ready at the booth. Can I smell like butt?
No, that's the savings room, remember?
Honey, can I talk to you? You don't have to do this.
What do you mean?
This isn't us. We're more stay-at-home, we're safe kind of people.
This is safe and fun. This will be a safe and fun time.
Just because the Petersons next to the door go on all those trips.
Let me tell you something. If I have to hear about one more of Heathcliff Peterson's outward bound excursions, I'm going to kick someone.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm just saying you don't have to one up anybody.
I'm doing this because I want to spend more time in the great outdoors. I don't have to one up Heathcliff because, first of all, he has a stupid name. Second, his shutters are blue. I mean, really. Third, he has a freaky looking kid. Freakier looking kid.
Okay.
All right, everybody, let's load up the canoe. Okay, Sherry, when I tell you to, I want you to hand me the oars.
Okay. Are we in a fight? This isn't how I wanted to spend today. I brought you out here to our place so you can relax.
It's not making me relax.
Why not?
I'm antsy.
What can I do?
Nothing.
Just tell me.
There is nothing you can do. Corey, I want to go to that Somali restaurant.
Fine. I'm full from this delicious sandwich anyway. We can probably swing by later and pick you up to take out if you want.
No, you don't understand. I want to go with someone who wants to go. I don't want to sit here on this nasty dog eating your mom's tuna fish. I want to sit down with someone at that Somali place and have an intelligent conversation. I'm sorry. I didn't mean that, Corey.
When did our conversations become nothing to you? When has my mom's sandwiches become not as good as something you haven't even tried before? What is wrong with the thing you've loved for the past 6 years? What's wrong with being out here, at our place? That used to be enough.
I had loosely been thinking about missing the opportunity to find out I might like something.
Or someone?
Or someone. More.
Once you're done with all the soul searching, after trying Somalian food or Korean food, or whatever else you decide you need to taste, the thing that you like the best, the thing that fills you up the most, is me.
If that's the case, hopefully it won't be too late.
It will be.
House her, him, and you. The mistake.
Actually, I'm a surprise.
Don't you get it? I'm not coming home.
Why do you have to fight with everyone all the time? Why do you have to be so mean to everyone? Why are you such a jerk?
I don't know.
Well, maybe it's too much caffeine in your diet or your polyunsaturated fats.
Sydney, like you said, I'm messed up. You can be better when I'm not here.
You take me back.
What? No, you found me. You can find your way home.
You would send me out into the wilderness? There are wolves out there!
Sydney, those are all.
Yes, there are. I saw a whole herd of them on the way here, and they look hungry.
Go.
They're gonna eat me.
You will be missed.
You would let the wolves kill me?
I would let the wolves eat you all up.
You're gonna miss me when I'm dead.
No, I'm not.
You never taught me how to swim.
So? Okay, let's go swimming right now. Oh, wait, you don't have your swimsuit. Sydney?
Yeah,
I don't have my swimsuit. What? No, this is ridiculous. Sydney, it's 20 degrees outside. Put on your coat and go home. I'm leaving, don't you get it? I'm not staying. So just go home, you make me sick. Get away from me.
I'm staying with you.
Say goodbye.